Okay, Coach. So, Luke Pletcher's a hammer.
Yeah.
Demetrius Thomas, when we have that Demetrius Thomas, look out world.
Yeah.
What about him just running through guys?
Yeah.
When you get those two guys, and those are two of your club guys, and they come out and perform like that, how much does that sell the Pittsburgh Wrestling Club?
Yeah, I mean, they're both really fun to watch compete, you know, but they're just great competitors, you know, and they're great to have in our club and you know, have our guys look up to guys like that go out and compete like that. You know, they're both out there trying to score points and you know, kind of fearless. And so it was a great performance by both those guys.
We're in this crazy COVID time. You're doing this balance of an ECC schedule, a Pittsburgh Wrestling Club, Wrestling Navy. Still doing some traveling, getting all your dates in, getting your minimum matches so you guys can get wild cards. What has it been like since that December event to now?
We've been fortunate. It's been pretty good for us. You know, I've seen a lot of teams canceling or postponing duels, and knock on wood, we haven't had that happen to us yet. You know, so you know, every time we get to compete, we feel lucky to be able to do it. You know, you wait for that last COVID test to come back negative, and it's all right. It's on. You know, so. We only have three more duels left, so it's fast season. But it's been, like I said, we've been fortunate to be able to compete every weekend.
Bring in there's not the availability of the college athletes tonight, so you brought in the middle schoolers and the youth, and you brought in the best youth wrestler in the country.
Yeah,
it's not even close. He's already beaten nationally ranked high school guys. Not like the 20th ranked high school guy. He's beaten the top five.
Yeah.
Okay, you bring Bo Bassett in, your brother comes in, they're local guys from not too far away.
Yeah.
What is it like to bring these youth guys into this event? And it's, the lights are on, and there's parents here watching them, and it's awesome.
Yeah, I hope it was cool for them. Really, the way that worked out was, I was talking with Jody Stripmatter about something different, and I mentioned that we were having this event. He said he'd had kids that would love to do it, and he offered. I mean, obviously, you know, I wouldn't be able to make those matchups. I just don't know that scene as well. But he did it all, you know. So Jody put those matchups together, and you know, we're thankful for him to be able to do that. And it was those kids were awesome, just watching them scrap out there, and I hope they enjoyed it too.
You look at the television exposure you guys are getting on the ACC. Mm-hmm. I've watched a bunch of your duels sitting at home on the couch in Chagrin Falls, Ohio.
Yeah.
That's amazing, right?
Yeah.
They're doing these Friday night duels.
Yeah.
It's awesome, man. Yeah. And they're time slotting it, so it's not really competing with the Big Ten totally. Yeah. How great is that for the growth of ACC wrestling and Pittsburgh wrestling?
Yeah, ACC is getting really good. I mean, I hope you didn't watch that last one we had.
I did. I did. Nino's got to pick a guy up who's 6'5" and put him down hard.
Yeah, no, that was a frustrating night, but I think that we'll be better from it, you know. But back to the point, the ACC, I think, it's crazy how fast that conference is growing, and we love being in the ACC. I mean, this weekend we have Virginia, and that's going to be a heck of a duel. It's a great opportunity for our guys. And so, I mean, especially with a shortened season like this, where we only have two out-of-conference matches and then our ACC schedule, we're getting tested, so we know we're going to be ready for the postseason. And so we're super fortunate to be in that conference and just filled with great coaches and competitors that are continuing to raise the bar.
Are guys going to have double-digit matches? There's a four-match threshold.
Yeah.
I know most of your guys are going to have the four-match threshold. Mm-hmm. Are guys going to have double-digit matches going into ACCs?
Our guys won't.
No, yeah,
no,
okay.
No, we have, I mean,
because there's,
I don't
doubles,
think so.
Though. Some of them you do doubles, some of them you don't. That's, that's what my confusion is, I guess.
Yeah, we've doubled up some of our guys.
Navy
in the beginning.
And Lehigh, doubled up.
We did, and then we do extra matches every duel, but sometimes you wrestle the extra matches, you wrestle like your backup or would be red shirts, you know. Navy worked out where we had everybody that went to that on that trip wrestled twice, you know, so we worked it out with them where, you know, our ones wrestled their ones, our twos wrestled their twos, and then we flip-flopped, you know. So everybody got two matches in that duel. So each duel is a little different, but all of our guys, you know, in the starting 10 have their four matches already. And, you know, our extra matches from here on out are probably going to be the guys that are our younger guys or, you know, that need more experience.
The University of Michigan's in the middle of, like, a nightmare scenario.
Yeah.
I mean, it makes me sick to think about the team they have, too.
Yeah.
They have a team that could, they can win.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Well, you and I aren't crazy. They got two Olympians. They're really good.
Yeah.
How does Pitt stay out of that nightmare scenario that Michigan's in?
man, I don't know. I mean, you get lucky, you know, and that's because it sounds like, I don't know the ins and outs of that whole situation, but it sounds like that was an athletic department, like the whole.
It's all, yeah, no, it's all shut down. Yeah,
it's not just wrestling. So, yeah, you know, I think that we just have to hope for the best and get lucky, because that's not just on the wrestling team. You know, that's all the whole athletic department over there. So, yeah, it's a crazy year. And then back to what I was saying, I mean, it's like every time you get to compete, it's, you know, you're lucky. So we're almost at the end. So hopefully we make it.
You're telling me. You got anything else for me?
No. Thanks for covering it. And hope everybody enjoyed it.
Coach, thank you for the time. H2P. Give me an H2P.
H2P. Helipit.
Yes. Both of my neighbors are pit rats.
There you go.
And I cut
wood.
You
live in a good neighborhood.
Great neighborhood.
Very intelligent.
Best neighbors ever, man. Yeah. I got the best neighbors ever. Both pit grads. My neighbor lady was a pit cheerleader, so.
There you go.
H2P, we wear pit stuff. Thank you for the time. Oh!
Yep.
Oh!
You got
I got the hookup.
Yeah, you did.
I got the hookup, Coach. Thank you for the time, H2P.
Yep, thank you.